Hi everyone, welcome to victoriapiking.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make authentic Korean galbi or barbecue short ribs. It's amazing, relatively simple dish to make, and it's just fabulous. So I hope you enjoy the idea and stay tuned. Let's start with my favorite topping. This is pickled radish. This is Korean radish, and this is how it looks like. Now take a piece, about 200 grams or just a thick piece, and shred it. I'm shredding it on this beautiful shredder, but if you like, you can do it with a tiny slice of radish as well. Thinly and round slices will work beautifully as well here.
After it's cut or grated, or I don't know how to say it, and it's beautiful, up to your liking, add a bit salt, quite important, and a rice vinegar. Now at this point, classical to add about a tablespoon of sugar. The thing is that I'm not a big fan of sugar, so it's up to you. I love them tangy, so I will write the how many things you need to add it, and cover and add a little bit of water. Now don't add too much water, because if you will add too much water, they are going to be very watery, and they can overflow, because they are going to, you know, to take the water and moisture out of them. A bit of cold water, and that's it. Let it stand. It's cold water. I'm just using like boiled from kettle and cooled completely, and let it stand. Mix it and let it stand, I don't know, for the night to soak up the flavors, or a couple of hours will be enough. Frankly, you can start eat it as it is. It's very crunchy and fresh. But if you want it pickly, let it stand for the night. Mix it slightly and let it go down for a little bit. That's it. And into refrigerator. Okay. Now we're adding garlic. Two garlic cloves, and I have here little helper to help me with the recipe. Okay, little helper left now. He has this, you know, inside here something, so it hurts. So he just a little left me, but it's okay. Little ginger.
Sesame seed. Oil goes in.
I'm using a Japanese one, but you can find Korean one, at least in Vancouver or Vancouver area, you can find it very easily. And sesame seed. Onion goes inside as well. Cup of soy sauce. And third cup of soju. Now, soju, it's a spirit, Korean spirit. You don't have to use it. This is basically water, alcohol, and sugar, a little sweetened alcohol, and it's really nice. Frankly, Now the soju goes in third cup as well. You can use rice wine, or you can just use wine to this. Teaspoon of dark sugar. Another teaspoon goes in. And they use corn syrup. There is Korean corn syrup apparently, but I can't find Korean corn syrup, so I'm using a little bit of agave. About 2 teaspoons more. And mix all together very well. Take your short ribs, and I have wonderful short ribs here, there. Cover them very thoroughly with all the marinade and leave them for about 2 hours in refrigerator to marinate. You can leave them overnight as well. Thank you, little helper. Add a little bit black pepper on top. Frankly, you should have been add it inside the marinade, but we forgot a little bit, so we are adding on top and mix it all. No, to brush it with cooking oil. I'm using the avocado oil, but you can use any oil that you have on hand. Just a little bit and preheat it. Okay. Preheat it to pretty high. You can use any grill. If you have charcoal grill, it's even better. Korean style grills are a little bit different shape. I will insert the photo here if I can find them. They're rounder. It's hard to explain, but anyhow, I have this pretty cool grill in here.
Make sure that the grill is cold when you put the oil on top, otherwise it will be splattering everywhere. And cook the ribs for about 4 to 5 minutes per side, or until it's beautifully done and you have those beautiful marks on top. For serving, we need leaves. Those are sesame leaves.
And I could buy them in a Korean shop, and they look like this. No, there are 3 of them in the package. But you probably won't be able to find it in North America so easily. So what you can do, just lettuce leaves. On lettuce leaves, you add, obviously, kimchi. Now, the recipe of kimchi is down below if you want your own. I bought it as well, and they make it on the spot in the shop. So it's pretty authentic and nice kimchi. It's made by Korean, for Korean, which I love it. I think the authentic is very important part of at least my life. So a little bit of kimchi goes on the leaf, like so. You can add a little bit more kimchi, a little bit less kimchi. It's up to you. I love a lot of kimchi, so probably I will add a little bit more of it even here, like so. Now the radish. You remember the pickled radish that I made earlier? So this, a little bit of radish on top. And the meat. Okay, Koreans use a lot of scissors when it's come to food. So they just cut the bones out and they cut piece of it on each one. Basically, every person will make a little bit of the sandwiches by himself, and he will put as much or as little as kimchi or whatever he likes on this leaf. So it's up to you. Or a lettuce leaf, for this matter. Beautiful. This is gorgeous.
The meat was unusual. That little tiny dish part I liked. The only thing I didn't like, I was chewing it, the leaf and everything, and then the leaf burst flavor. A bad flavor I didn't like. I like the radish and the meat together, but not the leaf. Not the leaf. Actually, the kimchi was kind of good in there. That's kind of good.
Now let's try it. So you basically take the leaf, like so, and you make a little bit small pocket, and all of this go to your mouth.
One, two, three.
The leaf has absolutely peppery taste to it. It's not hot or something, but it's very unique and peppery. My son didn't love it with the peppery taste, but he loved it with lettuce leaves. It's awesome. And the flavor, all of the layers are amazing. The kimchi, the radish adds a lot of crunch, and the meat is hot and wonderful, and it just comes all together and sweet, and it's amazing. So I hope you really enjoy the idea. You will give it a go. And don't forget to subscribe, write me a comment, thumbs up me, and cheers, Victoria. Love you all. See you next time. Bye. Yes, and please follow me on Pinterest, on Facebook, on all my social media. The links are down below. Thank you for being with me. Love you. Bye.